beautiful. But sometimes I feel so unsuitable, and it drowns out what's musical. Then I find myself drinking and thinking, making no terms yet my signal is blinking.
I don't think this yellow cobalt is ever going to be able to make this left, so we might be here for a while. We're gonna check it out and see what we got at the St. Augustine Flea Market. Open 9 a.m. to 4 p.m., which is quite late for a flea market, I might add. Considering Webster's closes up by noon, I don't think this yellow cobalt is ever gonna be able to make this left, so we might be here for a while.
Let's go straight back that way. Yes, we're open. Fresh cooked pork rinds. I stay refined, no swine. Maybe get some gator jerky. Boiled nuts. Mikey's mobile kitchen with an IE. Yeah.
It's Master Ace. Cunning linguist. About to get into the seasons. Seasons of hip hop. We gonna start it.
Yeah.
As we spring back to the past, it was all happening fast. We glorified coke and smoke and crack in a glass. When B-boys danced to the latest jam, you could say this man was the greatest fan. When shoelaces were fat and all the rappers' faces were black and light brown, a box with the right sound was all you needed. When it blasts, they must move. You just prove you hard like L and Crush Groove. The song started to drop, ain't nobody started the top. Before Preem learned the art of the chop. This is way before SPs and MPCs, and long before CDs and MP3s. The game start to bloom and blossom, and masters ready for the ceremony like a groom in costume. Growth from the rain of the previous years. I took notes from what I heard through these devious ears.
And summer's heat waves ascended in its splendid manner. Greens was flooding, I seen, although the skin was tanner. Fuck the police, jumping over radio scanners. It was hot in the shade, wet paint all over the canvas. Fuck vanilla ice cones, we had tea cubes, America's most, and wanted that chronic on the left coast. Talent pools were full and fresh for swimming. Backstroking through dark sides and neomatic beginnings. Them lemonade stands will make you street platinum. It was too live, over the cruise called heat for rapping. But free speech, pollination, kept bees colonizing in hives. And sung the Loris Tucker right in a pride. The tribe's ocean splash was rising the tide. Strictly for my niggas that were ready to die in the ride. I wish the summer's vibe could have lasted forever. Too bad we had to have a change in that weather. That shit was beautiful.
Seasons change, mad things rearrange. Play me in the winter, play me in the summer, play me in the order, any order. Seasons change, mad things rearrange.
White and green turn yellow brown, autumn. See, all them leaves must fall down.
As the east versus west winds blew, causing two legends to fall like maple leaves from escalated beef. Assume that the worst was over till these cats started wearing shiny costumes like the 31st of October. The weather's colder, but the word jacket is what they did to people's styles, not what they covered their backs with. Tactics of the skill impaired, no limit to what they'll do when the green is scarce. Some be Thanksgiving for who they know, while others get jerked for loot. Cause getting signed ain't a turkey shoot. No respect for the pilgrims who paved the way so you could rock that. It's pop crap and Plymouth rock rap. Beyond gimmicks and fake plastic tits, outcast the Raekwon drop fall classic discs. Born to roll, so I'm taking you back to school days of autumn before the bottom dropped out in 2K.
By the dawn of the new millennium, we saw bright change. When it brought along platinum, causing an ice age. No more cold, no more yo MTV raps. Now we got R&B cats selling classic rap tracks. In winter it snowed in like the temperatures below 10. Citizens open up shows for more snowmen. Scrawny boys rock bubble gooses to pose like grown men. And you can catch freezer burn from women when they show skin.
I'm different, so don't compare me to another. I'm different, so don't compare me to another. I'm different, so don't compare me to another. Cause they can't hang. Word to the mother.
I'm not like anyone else, so don't you think about my suggestions. He rap like so-and-so, ayo, you know that's out of the question. Plus it don't sound right, cause I don't sound like him. Or try to G like, C like, or even B like them. Or anyone else, I'm going for self. You open your mouth and then I stuff you. You're like a floor walked on wax and then I buff you. Plus you think you're tough too? With your garbage style, rubbish nothing but trash. You wanna try me? Come on, I got some shit for that ass. I never be weak, those off, go to sleep or get tired. Put wings on your head, so it's easier to fly it. Off you go, fly off the block. Get funky on you suckers like a gym sweat sock. Cause I tear up to inflict, pick your hair up like a pick. Ed OG, dearest me, I make medicine sick. I'm never taking a loss, but beat them down with force. Go with their as a source. I got my holes in a golf course. It's a lyrical lesson, so you lose as you learn. Whack raps are like me gym hats, shit break and get burned. So I did it to compare me to a soft hearted sucker. I'm different, so don't compare me to another.
I'm different, so don't compare me to another. I'm different, so don't compare me to another. I'm different, so don't compare me to another. Cause they can't hang. Word to the mother.
Some of the people wanna be equal, wishing that they could be me. There never be none, got many to one in the east, so don't attempt to be. Thinking that you could do that. Boy, if you only knew that, I can't hold back. Stop you, sucker, I enjoy that. My impact on contact will overlap your whack rap, your step tracks, exact to react and attack the whack. I won't slack, but smoke smack, slap you sap. Straight your soft, so I put you in stacks. And stop the sucker, then it distracts. Taking apart you back to the max. Waking the wonderful words, rubbing you up and then wax. Never ever taking a half step. You did, so that's your last step. This left joke was strep throat, so now one but bust your rep, dropping this strictly on the metropolis. No comp for this, so why do you persist to this? Go ahead and attempt to. You better be filing exempt too, cause you're a student who's intruding out of your district. Oh well, another statistic. While I'm stating a swift style strictly, then switching this, swarming a storm somehow and leaving you shitless. Smoke smack slap you sap, you are a sickness. Step and stand still, boy, so I can stick this sword of rap straight up your spine sap, so you will be too scared to swallow my style in your stomach. Let me shoot my sperm until she screams and squirms. See, but don't sweat that, I got a gym mat for safety. So I did it to compare me to a soft-hearted sucker. I'm different, so don't compare me to another.
I'm different, so don't compare me to another. I'm different. Don't compare me to another. I'm different, so don't compare me to another. Cause they can't hang. Word to the mother.
OG's a posing threat to be dreaded. To those I beheaded, the rest just sweated. But some of them are skeptical, so I step with full pack force. And you know what? I wreck the hoe. So don't put yourself in that predicament, because I'm sick of it. And you'll go out quicker than Bounty. The quicker to pick her up, or while I soak them, I might choke them or even smoke them. Nah, but I'll max and I'll just tax and keep scooping them up by onesies, just like Jack. See, I compete with the weak I come across. I'm too elite to defeat. Step off, cause you're soft when I elaborate. With bullet and smooth, I collaborate in a state that's straight that you hate. After this, I'll be famous, but not the same as those who proclaim this. I leave them nameless. Thinking you're hard with your backup, punk, don't make me crack up by yourself. You'll just choke up and plus get smoked up. So I dare you to compare me to a soft-hearted sucker. I'm different, so don't compare me to another.
I'm different, so don't compare me to another. I'm different, so don't compare me to another. I'm different, so don't compare me to another. Cause they can't hang. Word to the mother. I'm different, so don't compare me to another. I'm different, so don't compare me to another. I'm different, so don't compare me to another. Cause they can't hang. Word to the mother. I'm different, so don't compare me to another. I'm different, so don't compare me to another. I'm different, so don't compare me to another. Cause they can't hang. Word to the mother. I'm different, so don't compare me to another. I'm different, so don't compare me to another. I'm different, so don't compare me to another. Cause they can't hang. Word to the mother. I'm different, so don't compare me to another. I'm different, so don't compare me to another. I'm different, so don't compare me to another. Cause they can't hang. Word to the mother.
Say, just thought of something. If you're not busy this evening, how'd you like to attend a voodoo ceremonial worship?
Gentlemen, my name is Horrible Harris, and I'm the convict they let out tonight to drive this contraption. So be nice to me. I could take it offline, but I'm trying to get early parole, so I'll try to be good for you folks. No notes of safety, gang. Just be seated while the trolley's in motion, and we'll get along just fine. And anyhow, the ghosts are waiting for us, so without further ado, give a big hand to our fantabulous ghostess, hostess Gabby, who knows all the haunted stories of St. Augustine. Yay!
All right, Gabby! Yay. Yeah! Ghost.
That's me. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Welcome to St. Augustine, and welcome aboard Ghost and Gravestones. My name is Ghostly Gabby the Ghost. I'll be your hostess for tonight. Our driver tonight is Harris. Quick, welcome in. And tonight, you all are in for a very spooktacular treat. You all are coming with us on a journey to the dark side of St. Augustine. Tonight, you all will be hearing a lot of different stories that detail the history, the haunts, and the ghosts that plague the city. And along the way, we'll be making several stops at a few of St. Augustine's notoriously haunted hotspots. Hopefully, though, with this experience, you all will be able to come up with your own conclusions about the paranormal. Because the funny thing about ghosts is, while we don't exactly know for sure why they are here, we do know that they are here. So, who is ready to begin our adventure to the dark side tonight?
everybody.
I see the front row is. It's okay, though. We still have the rest of the tour to get you all ready. Well, Harris, are you ready to go, too?
We're ready.
That's the spirit. And to those that aren't quite ready yet, sorry, but it's too late to back out now. Let's begin on a cold, windy day in 1821. A cargo ship coming all the way from Havana, Cuba, sailed into the St. Augustine Harbor. And when the ship was boarded to collect the supplies, what was found on board besides supplies turned out to be a big shock. You see, also found on board the ship were all of the bodies of the sailors and captain, and big swarms of infected mosquitoes and flies. Somehow that swarm managed to find its way to St. Augustine, and it caused the epidemic that plagued the city, the yellow fever, which was so widespread and rampant that it lasted all the way into the fall of that year and wiped out about one-third of St. Augustine's entire population. That is a lot of people who are all buried within the walls of the Huguenot Cemetery over here on your right-hand side. In the late 1600s. During that time, English pirates wound up plaguing the Florida coast and the Spanish inhabited city of St. Augustine. They went for the Spanish treasure ships docked out in the harbor, and among these pirates was their leader named Andrew Ransom. Fortunately, though, the treasure wasn't easy for the pirates to get away with, and as soon as they were captured, they were brought to the governor of the city, who decided that, to be fair, their sentencing was actually going to be split in half. Andrew Ransom's crew were sentenced to help build the fort Castillo de San Marco with the other workers. But since he was the leader of the pack, he was going to be made an example of. So the governor sentenced Ranton to be brought to the town square the very next day, where he would be publicly executed by guillotine. For those of you that aren't familiar with this type of method of execution, it's a good thing I have a real-life garrote display right over here next to me with the rope already intact, so that a way for me to explain what happened next with Andrew Ranson's execution is actually to demonstrate how a garrote works. Can I you come up here, please? You're gonna take two steps up and put your back against the board. Yeah, don't worry, though, I'm not gonna kill you. This is the demonstration of a garrote. But before I start, can I get your name real quick? Chris? Okay. The very next day, the governor brought Andrew Ranson to the town square, where everyone in town had gathered up to watch his execution. As he stood upon the garrote, the executioner read out the name and crimes of the guilty one.
You are found guilty of the crime of piracy, and have been sentenced to death by garrote. I have already pulled the rope from the post behind this pirate. Now I shall bring it around his scrawny little neck. I shall pull it back to the post behind this pirate, where I will tie it off at the tod. I'm going to smooth. And afterwards, all of you were invited over to the governor's mansion for tea and cookies. Yes, but not you though.
Okay then, alright. Speaking of the governor though, he was the one who in fact was the most excited to watch this fearsome pirate be executed. As the executioner prepared to begin twisting the rope, the crowd watched anxiously. The soldiers placed bets on how they twist the bottom and take. But don't worry, Chris is hanging there. With the first turn of the rope!
What's our hatred in that voice?
Sorry. With the first turn of the rope!
First turn of the rope! Make it a little bit more dramatic.
With the first turn of the rope!
Wrong answer. It doesn't really matter if you're ready, does it? That was a funny. See, I made it funny. With the first turn of the rope, they car sprayed the pirates, bit to the pirate's neck. And yet the pirate remains eerily calm. The second turn of the rope, somebody in the crowd said, "He's holding something!" Someone else said, "It looks like Captain Crew's repeat!" That's nonsense! What were the English pirates doing holding Captain Crew's repeat? Yeah. With the third turn of the rope, the pirate began to show difficulty breathing.
I have a cough drop.
Difficulty breathing. That's probably the best I'm gonna get, isn't it?
Yeah.
Alright. With the fourth turn of the rope, rope bound toward the pirate's skin. It was a trickle of blood. We're almost there. With the fifth turn of the rope, pirate's face turned purple. His tongue stuck out. Hey, put that back in there. Don't do that again. That's disgusting. And with the sixth turn of the rope, And the pirate breathed in a huge gasp of air. Hello. And as the time stood still, the crowd, as one, gasped and stood motionless. as a Catholic priest knelt at the martyr's feet.
We have seen a miracle. This man is saved. Sanctuary. The Holy Son of God, that's funny. All right. We're going back to the ghost stories now. And since we have the Bayfront here on your right, let's go all the way back to the very beginning when St. Augustine was found in 1565. Originally, the name of the Bayfront was called the Bay of Dancing Dolphins, but it wound up getting renamed Matanzas Bay, which is Spanish for massacre and slaughter. In the very beginning, the famous Pedro Menendez was having a conflict going on between his newly arrived Spanish fleet and the French. Ultimately, though, the French wound up being defeated by September Florida hurricane that came off the coast and left about 200 survivors. The sailors managed to float right up to the shore, and Pedro had them captured while giving them this sweet ultimatum and a chance to get away with their lives. He said, if you renounce your French Huguenot faith and convert to become a Catholic, I will let you go. But if you don't, I will have to execute you. They said no. So the next day, he ordered all the soldiers to bring the sailors down to the sandy dunes around the Matanzas Inlet. And as each and every one of the sailors were forced to kneel side by side, shoulder to shoulder, they were all put to death that very day. Not a single sword was spared by the soldiers' swords. All the blood that ran in actually caused the waters to turn red and stay red for 3 days straight. That's a lot of blood. And the Bay of Dancing Dolphins was renamed the Matanzas Bay. In the present day, though, many people who find themselves near the waters of the Bayfront, especially on the nights of the full moon, have claimed to see a lot of strange paranormal activity going on. Some people have seen the waters of the Bayfront turn red, perhaps signifying all the blood that was shed during the massacre. Some people have seen pairs of eyes looking up at them from the waters below. Perhaps they're all the spirits of the fallen French that had died during the massacre. Some people have seen a bright green ball of light slowly rise above the waters. And some people have seen a glowing apparition of a Spanish soldier at the edge of the Bayfront area who completely vanishes as soon as you take a second look right back at him. So it seems that to this day, the water of the Bayfront is still trying to tell the story on how it received the tragic name, the Matanzas Bay. If I didn't mention this before, we are actually getting dangerously close to stop number 2. This is going to be inside the most haunted building in downtown St. Augustine itself, the Old Jail. Hopefully anyone who's wearing stripes makes it out of there at the end, because I have actually had people wearing stripes mysteriously go missing whenever I take groups inside there. I don't know where they go, but they do often go missing. So folks, grab your safety buddies, and inside we go.
I was known as a fugitive. I ran like a rebel in 85. Cops tried to catch me, cause all of them said I beat up these other men who were bigger than me. Was it cause I'm black and they were W-H-I-T-E? Here I was walking down the block. I seen these two big bikers standing by the biker shop. They seen it was me, so to make the cell feel bigger, one got bad bull pointed and called me a nigga. I stuck my finger up, I said his mother, and kept stepping. His friend told his other friend, hey Corky, let's get him. I looked to my back, to my surprise, one had a chain in his hand and the devil in his eye. I said, I'm in trouble, let me think real quick. I looked down on the ground and got this big fat brick. With no time to waste, I put the brick in my hand and hit the bike until the chain fell out of his sand. Then his friend cried, he said, Corky, are you alright? But what he didn't know was he was in for a fight. The right hit his jaw, he fell on the floor. The kid I hit with the brick before said, don't hit him anymore. I put my brick down, left him on the ground. Everything was cool till the cops came around. They said, you're under arrest for assault 2 and 3. I laughed at the cop, I said, explain this to me. He said, you hit the man with the brick and punched another in the jaw and left the scene like nothing happened. Then they called the law. I laughed in his face, I said, this don't make sense. It was 2 against my black ass, this makes it self-defense. He tried to grab me, so I pushed him on the floor and ran my black ass home and locked the living room door. I did what any black kid would have did, but till the cops was up for county, I'm known as a fugitive. As a fugitive. needed if the cops was up the county. I'm known as a fugitive. Go to school. I couldn't be late if I missed another day. Miss Kant said I wouldn't graduate. I didn't go a lot. That didn't mean I didn't care. I had to come to school more often to try again next year. Fuck that. I went to school and I tried, you know, to hide from the cops to June of 85. I get my diploma and things will be straight. By that, my graduation cops came and tried to put me on the gate. I ran, though, with the diploma that I own. With cops chasing me all the way till I got home. I got away again. Why? You know what I did? I ran my black ass home, and to them, I'm still a fugitive. Fugitive. I'm still a fugitive. Still the cops of Suffolk County. I'm still a fugitive. Went by me running from the cops. My mom looked at my dad said, son, this has gotta stop. Dad gave my money, she said, son, this is for ya. I went to Garden City to go get me a lawyer. I went to jail, Monday I was in jail. Through Friday when you're black and you're in trouble, man, does your lawyer get paid? Then my mom told the judge, my son's a good child. Then he laughed at my mother and said they'd take us to trial. I told my mom and dad I felt within. If we took Suffolk County to court or trial, I know I wouldn't win. So without a doubt, like any black kid in Suffolk County, KSOLO had to cop out to 16 months in Riverhead. Instead of fighting and wilding, I wrote my records instead. Commissary was boards, inmates, old me COs would beat me up with shakedowns. But now those suckers know me and I laugh at the cops who arrest me for what I did. Cause I'm hooked and no longer am I a fugitive. Fugitive. I was a fugitive. The cops in Suffolk County, known as a fugitive.
Getting back from a dig. Here's what the back of the car could look like on any given dig. Yeah, check it out. We found that California Raisins lunchbox last week. Found the fucking board game this week, along with the $6 million man and Laverne and Shirley and this other dope joint. And there's supposed to be a happy day. I think I fucking left it there. Wait. A disco ball, a skeleton. Check out this angel cycle. It's like a 1970s chopper. This cheap plastic toy, but it's dope. Reminds me of like Speed Buggy, Goober and the Ghost Chasers. We also got a couple disco balls with the fucking motor that rotates them. Some old blocks there. Fucking micro cassette recorder. It's got like some little girl singing on it. Yeah, gonna sample her and shit. Let's go viral with that. Oh yeah, and of course there were some records. I actually found some metal and stuff. Not metal, but some Nazareth. There was some Jimi Hendrix, a couple other joints. I think that's a Crosby, Stills and Nash, Foreigner. Oh shit. Yeah. What do we got here? Nazareth. Nothing like a chicken high heels, skimpy clothes and a skirt in the men's room, head games. I knew it had to be the one with Dirty White Boy on it. Yeah, Deep Crate's Dirty White Boy coming at you. Some Walking Dead shit too.